Hi, I'm Betty. Welcome to Betty's Kitchen. Today we're making rhubarb sundaes. Or you could think of it just as rhubarb syrup, and you may use that syrup on pound cake, waffles, or anything that you'd like. Into a medium-sized saucepan, we're putting 1½ cups of finely chopped rhubarb. I don't think I have done a rhubarb recipe in Betty's Kitchen, but I grew up with growing rhubarb, so I'm very familiar with it. It is very sour, so you may be surprised at the amount of sugar I add with this, but it is this plant that you can get at your grocery store, and you usually just pick the stems that you want and weigh them, and this would be about 6 ounces or so. But it's 1½ cups, and you want to chop it fairly finely. To this, I'm adding 1 cup of white sugar. Now, if you like things really tart, you could go with less, but in general, you're going to need that sugar. Then add 1 cup of water. So this is really like a simple syrup, except we are adding a flavor, which is from this particular fruit or vegetable. I don't know which it is. So I'm taking this to the stove, and I'm going to bring this to a boil, and I'm going to stand here and stir until the sugar is dissolved. You can see that my rhubarb mixture is beginning to boil, so I'm going to turn my heat down to low. I had it on medium, turning it down to low, and I'm going to let it simmer for 3 minutes. My rhubarb mixture has been simmering for 3 minutes. And here it is. And you can see the consistency of the rhubarb is that it's kind of mushy right now, and it looks like it's in very small pieces, so it has shrunk somewhat. Now, this is too hot to serve on anything, so you need to let it cool. And for our purposes, which I'm just going to put it on some vanilla ice cream, we need it at least cool to room temperature, and maybe even farther than that. So I'm going to let it sit at room temperature, and then at some point I'll probably put it in the refrigerator and then come back and make our sundaes. We're going to assemble our sundaes. Here we have our rhubarb syrup, and after it cooled to room temperature, I did refrigerate it. So if you're going to put it over ice cream, you'll want it chilled. So we'll just go to one of these glasses I've prepared with a few scoops of vanilla ice cream and just pour it over. And it will thicken up a little bit because it will be chilled by the ice cream. So that's about what that one gets. And then a sprig of mint. And then our other one, same way. And that's our resulting sundae. So here we have rhubarb sundaes. I have my serving right here, and I'm bringing over my little pitcher that has the rhubarb syrup because I want to take a taste, mainly tasting for the sugar. It's just perfect. I really like rhubarb, but it's sour. This is still tart, but it's sweetened down by that sugar until it's really very good. With ice cream, you may like it even better. It's really an interesting combination, and probably not something that you typically find at your grocery store, vanilla and rhubarb ice cream. So enjoy the sundaes.